Take a moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, you're lifting my load again. Take a moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, you're lifting my load again. There you go, lifting my load again. Take a moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, lifting my load again. A moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, lifting my load again. There you go, lifting my load again. There you go, lifting my load again. Take a moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, lifting my load again. Take a moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, lifting my load again. There you go, lifting my load again. 'Cause no longer am I held by the yoke of this world. I come up under the yoke of Jesus. His yoke is easy, his burden is so light. No longer am I held by the yoke of this world. I come up under the yoke of Jesus. His yoke is easy, his burden is so light. Oh, his burden is so light. His burden is so light. His burden is so light. Lifting my load, lifting my load, you're 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 lifting my load. Lifting my load, you're 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 lifting my load. No longer am I held by the yoke of this world. Come up under the yoke of Jesus. His yoke is easy, his burden is so light. No longer am I held by the yoke of this world. I come up under the yoke of Jesus. His yoke is easy, his burden is so light. 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 Take a moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, lifting my load again. Take a moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, lifting my load again. There you go, lifting my load again. There you go, you're lifting my load again. You're lifting my load. You're lifting my load. God who sees it all, a God who knows it all, a God who sees the end from the beginning, a God to be fully trusted, a God who is faithful, you're lifting the slow, you're lifting the slow. Lifting the slow, you're lifting the slow. Your love carries. Your love carries me through all the valleys and the darkest places. Your love carries me through all the valleys and the darkest places. Your love carries. Your love carries me through all the valleys and the darkest places. Your love carries me through all the valleys and the darkest places. Lifting the slow, you're lifting the slow, you're lifting the slow, you're lifting the slow. This world, I come up under the yoke of Jesus. His yoke is easy, his burden is so light. No longer am I held by the yoke of this world. I come up under the yoke of Jesus. His yoke is easy, his burden is so light. 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 trusting you. I'm learning, I'm learning how to trust in you. I'm learning how to trust in you. To breathe in deep, I'm learning to let it go. I'm learning to unclench my fist and trust in you, simply trust in you. Learning to breathe in deep. I'm learning to let it go. I'm learning to unclench my face and open up my hands and trust in you. Just to trust in you. Me through all the valleys and the darkest places. Your love carries me through all the valleys and the darkest places. So turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face and the things of earth will grow strangely. In the light of his glory and grace, turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. Of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory. And Jesus. Look full in His wonderful face and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of His glory. Shine the light of Your face upon us and chase the shadows away. Oh, come and shine the light of Your face upon us and chase the shadows away. Come and shine the light of Your face upon us and chase the shadows away. You change everything. You change everything when You come. Oh, You change everything. How oh, You change everything. You change everything. You step into the room. So come and shine the light of Your face upon us and chase the shadows away. Come and shine the light of face upon us and chase the shadows away, disarming anxiety. Disarming anxiety. Disarming anxiety. You're disarming anxiety. So put me anywhere, just put your glory in me, and I'll serve anywhere. Just let me see your beauty, so put me anywhere. Put your glory in me, and I'll serve anywhere. Just let me see your beauty, God, let me see your beauty. God, let me see your beauty. Everything with the light of your face, how you change everything, how you change everything, how you change everything in the light of your face. The light of your face. Trust in the one who knows. to trust in the one who never fails. I'm learning to trust, to hope and abide. I'm learning to trust in the one who never fails. Trust in you again. So I let go. I breathe in deep. Open up my hands. Trust in you again. You brought me to the end of myself. And this has been the longest road. Just when my hallelujah was tired, you gave me a new song. I'm letting go. to the end of myself. And this has been the longest road. Just when my hallelujah was tired, you gave me a new song. If I lived 1,000 lifetimes, wrote a song for every day, so there would be no way to say how you have loved me. If I lived a thousand lifetimes, wrote a song for every day, so there would be no way to say how you have loved me. If I lived a thousand lifetimes, wrote a song for every day, so there would be no way to say how you have loved me. If I lived a thousand lifetimes, wrote a song for every day, so there would be no way to say how you have loved me. Oh, how you've loved me.
His burden is so light.
lifting my Lord. You're 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 lifting my Lord. So take a moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, lifting my load again. Take a moment to remember who God is and who I am. There you go, lifting my load again. Oh, there you go, lifting my load again. There you go, you're lifting my load again. Carries me through all the valleys and the darkest places. Your love carries me through all the valleys and the darkest places. Your love carries me through all the valleys and the darkest places. Your love carries me through all the valleys and the darkest places. Even through the valley, oh, your love carries me. Your word carries me. Your promises carry me. Your faithfulness carries me. Steadfastness carries me. Oh, how your love carries me. Cause you remind me of things forgotten. You unwind me till I'm totally with your arms around me. Fear was no match for your love. Now you've won me. You remind me of things forgotten. You unwind me till I'm totally undone.
find our rest in you. We lay down our burdens. We lay down our anxieties. We find our rest in you. Our confidence lies in who you are, your unchanging, your faithful nature. Of your faithfulness, of your character today as we pray. Amen. So this morning, we're going to go into a time of praying for North Korea. And we'll be praying through the Word of God, through Ezekiel 37. But before we actually do that, we want to take some time to pray and lift up a current event situation. So as you may or may not have heard or read, North Korea has actually just made its biggest and most overt threat in its nearly three decades of missile testing. They actually just launched a missile over Japan, and it landed on the eastern shores of Japan. And this was actually a direct response to the joint U.S.-South Korean military drills. And it's the most serious and provocative missile launch to date. And in addition to this, North Korea has also been advancing and accelerating their weapons program. And so in light of that, we want to pray for this situation, for the people of the nations involved. As believers in Christ, we are given the authority to pray, and we're given the authority to fight not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities. Our fight is not against what we see in the natural, but it's in the spirit. So I invite you right now to take up your authority in Christ and to fight in the spirit, not striving in the flesh, but knowing that we have the divine power to demolish strongholds, that we have the power to come against everything that sets itself up against the knowledge of Christ, against the peace of Christ, against the love of God. And so we're going to pray both for the situation and for international relations, as well as people. So first, I want us to pray for peace. Let's come against every fear tactic, every threat. And let's pray for peaceful conversation between every country involved, the U.S., South Korea, Japan, China, North Korea. Let's pray wisdom and heavenly strategy over the leaders in conversation. Yeah, just declare the peace of Christ. And secondly, over the people of the nations involved, including ourselves, as we are people living in South Korea at the moment, I want us to pray rest and confidence in the sovereignty of God, confidence in the character of God, the unchanging nature of God, that He is not dethroned, He is not intimidated, He's not unsettled by any of this. So let's lift up those two things, peace over the situation, over the nations, and rest and confidence in who God is. Let's pray.
Thank you.
sit enthroned above it all. We put our trust in you. We put our trust and our confidence in you, Lord. We are not shaken by what we see and by what we hear here on this earth. But Lord, we trust in your word, who you say you are. We thank you, God, that you are sovereign. We thank you, Lord, for the peace that you're releasing. We thank you, Father. Yeah, we trust you. We lift this up to you, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Forever all my days, hallelujah. Hallelujah, our God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, our God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns forever all my days. Hallelujah, hallelujah, our God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns forever all my days. Hallelujah.
This time we'll continue to pray for North Korea through the Word of God. And so today we'll be meditating and praying, prophesying through the passage Ezekiel 37 verses 1 through 14. I invite you to open your Bibles to join us as we pray and sing through this passage over the nation of North Korea. Again, the passage is Ezekiel 37, verses 1 through 14. Ezekiel 37, verses 1 to 3. The hand of the Lord was upon me, and he brought me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the middle of the valley. It was full of bones, and he led me around among them. And behold, there were very many on the surface of the valley. And behold, they were very dry. And he said to me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, you know. Father, you know the plight of the North Korean people. You know their state so well. And you also know what you yourself are capable of doing. But God, just as you took Ezekiel in the middle of the valley and led him around the bones, I pray that you do the same for your sons and daughters, for your children of light in North and South Korea. Lord, it's so easy to feel overwhelmed by the destruction and the hopelessness that seems to cover the land. But Lord, you don't walk us through the valley to make us hopeless or to make us stay there. You do this so we can recognize and soberly assess the true state of things and acknowledge that you alone are God over it all, that you alone can save. You give us an opportunity to exercise faith. So Lord, won't you give the people of North Korea faith? We ask for a measure of faith that allows them to know that not only can you revive the bones, but that you desire to revive the bones. You desire to restore the destruction and oppression that has gripped the people with fear and even the very land with barrenness. Every amount of physical, mental, and emotional strife weighs on your heart. So God, lead us, lead your people through your heart, through an understanding of what breaks your heart. As those in South Korea, as we gain understanding of your heart, may we be moved to pray. And as those in North Korea gain understanding, may they receive healing in knowing how much your heart breaks for them. Give us a deeper understanding of your heart where we lack it. Give us a greater faith to come into agreement with you. For you know that these bones can live, but more than that, you desire that they do live, God.
Oh, I look hopelessness in the eye. like a dryness in the eye. I look at death in the eye and say that my God lives. Say that my God lives.
My God
is a God of the impossible. My God is the God of the impossible.
What no man can do, my God does.
My God is the God of the impossible.
Come and breathe hope upon us. Come and breathe.
My
hope.
God is the God of the impossible. My God is the God of the impossible. God is the God of the impossible.
Jesus, you've done what no man can do.
God is the God of the impossible. My God is the God of the impossible. All resurrection power is in our God. 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 In our God, all resurrection power is in our God. You see a grave as resurrection. You see a grave as resurrection. You see all dryness and weariness. Breathe life, or you speak life. You say these dead bones will live again. 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 'Cause all resurrection power is in our God. 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 So we'll see hopelessness in the eye. We'll see these bones in the eye. And we'll say, our God is a God of the impossible. Oh, my God is the God of the impossible. Oh, my God is the God of the impossible. My God is the God of the impossible.
Ezekiel 37, verses 4 to 6. Then he said to me, prophesy over these bones. Sigh over these bones and say to them, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter you and you shall live. And I will lay sinews upon you, and I will cause flesh to come upon you and cover you with skin and put breath in you, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am the Lord. Lord, you've given us the words of life to prophesy over North Korea. You've put your spirit within each of us. You've given us the ability to speak with authority in the name of Jesus. Your voice commands the wind, the waves, the mountains, every living thing on this earth. And so we believe not in our wise or persuasive words, not in how loudly we pray, but in the power of your word to speak for itself. So we simply prophesy. We command every dry bone in North Korea, every hopeless situation, every broken person, every desperate child and prisoner, we command them in faith to hear the word of the Lord. We say to you, you shall live and not die. He will be the one who comes into your helplessness, who comes into your infirmity. He will strengthen you with sinews, giving you the ability to move. He will give you form and protect you, give you covering. And more importantly, he will give you breath, the breath of life. You shall know that it's supernatural because it's not just a dead body that he's breathing into, but it's dry, scattered bones with hardly any form, with hardly any semblance of life. So we speak hope right now over North Korea, hope in this word of the Lord, hope for something out of nothing, hope for order out of chaos, hope in the same God who spoke, let there be light, the same God who formed Adam from dirt. In the same way, we prophesy now, let the people of North Korea know the power of speaking forth your word. Empower them to prophesy over themselves, over one another, over the dryness they see around them. Let not any force silence them from prophesying life, but let them speak, let them be heard, let them prophesy, let them hear the word of the Lord and then speak it.
Come to kill, to steal, to destroy. But you have come that we may have life and life to the full. Oh, the enemy has come to steal, to kill, to destroy. But you have come that we may have life and life to the full.
This is the good news.
Oh, you say they shall live and not
die.
You say they shall live and not die. You say they shall live and not die.
Prophesy. We speak forth your word.
You say they shall live and not die. We speak all your life to the full.
Life.
We speak your
abundant
life. Life to the
full.
We speak your life. Life to the full.
We
speak your life. Life to the full. We speak your life. Life to the full. We speak your life and life to the full. We speak your life and life to the full. We speak your life and life to the full. What do you say? Yes and amen. What you say is yes and amen.
All your promises are yes.
What you say is yes and amen. Oh, what you say is yes and amen.
You're pleased to do it, God. You're pleased to speak.
You shall live and you shall know that I am the Lord. Oh, you shall live and you shall know that I am the Lord. Oh, you shall live and you shall know. Bones, you shall live and you shall know that I am the Lord. Oh, you shall live and you shall know that I am the Lord. Hear, O dead bones, you shall live. You shall know that I am the Lord. These dead bones will live. These dead bones will rise. These dead bones will sing of his glories once again. Dead bones will live. These dead bones will live. These dead bones will rise. These dead bones will sing of his glories once again. These dead bones will live. Dead bones will live. These dead bones will rise. These dead bones will sing of his glories once again. These dead bones will live. These dead bones will live.
Ezekiel 37, verses 7 to 10. So I prophesied as I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a sound, and behold, a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to its bone. And I looked, and behold, there were sinews on them, and flesh had come upon them, and skin had covered them. But there was no breath in them. Then he said to me, prophesy to the breath, prophesy, son of man, and say to the breath, thus says the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe on these slain, that they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood on their feet, an exceedingly great army. Father, as your people on this peninsula prophesy in faith, believing without having yet seen, let us then see the manifestation of your word going forth. Let us see the breath of God instilling life, breathing on the slain, on the driest of dry bones. For we may not be able to see the breath of God, but we can see the evidence of movement as you breathe new life upon the people in this land. So Lord, let us see the sick healed. Let us see the hardest heart softened to the gospel. Let us see the prisoners set free. Let us see the soil become fertile and the land become fruitful. Let us see prison guards turn away from injustice and become radically transformed to win over their fellow guards to Christ. Let the weary missionaries and field workers gain a second, third, fourth wind to keep carrying your light. Let the atmosphere of heaven invade North Korea as you fill the people with your breath, giving them freedom and courage to worship you. Let the breath of God be irresistible. Let the breath of God be noticeably different from the routine, from the everyday that people go through. God, you are love, and everything about you is love. So let the essence of your love be felt as you breathe life upon North Korea. Yes, you want to bring healing and freedom and justice, but without love, it's all meaningless. You desire that your love be known, that your love be felt among a people that's so desperate for your touch. Come and breathe on them with your love and kindness. A breath that is so much more than functional, but a breath that is relational. A breath that says, I desire that you live, but I desire more that you live to know my love. So Lord, breathe on these slain that they may live to know your love.
As you breathe your breath of life, may we see heaven invade as you breathe.
God, just one breath of God.
Oh, how powerful. It's just one word from God. Just one word from God. Oh, how it changes everything. Just one breath from God. Just one breath from God. You can do the impossible. God, you can do the impossible. With just one word, with just one breath, you can do the impossible. You can do the impossible. You can do the impossible. With just one word, with just one breath, you can do the impossible. And all this pain, I wonder if I'll ever find my way. I wonder if my life could really change. Is lost ever be found? Could a garden come up from this ground at all? Cause you make beautiful things, you make beautiful things out of dust. Things you make beautiful things out of us, and all around, hope is springing up from this old ground. Out of chaos, life is being found. Springing up from this old ground, out of chaos, life is being found in you. You make beautiful things, you make beautiful things out of dust. You make beautiful things, you make beautiful things out of us. You make beautiful things, you make beautiful things out of dust. Out of us, you make beautiful things, you make beautiful things out of us, you make beautiful things, you make beautiful things out of us. You us out of dust. You make beautiful things. You make beautiful things out of us. And you make me new. You are making me new. You make me new. You are making me new. You make me new. You are making me new. You make me you are making me new. And all around, hope is springing up from this old ground. Out of chaos, life is being found in
this time. We'll continue to pray for North Korea, this time through intercession topics that will be shown on the screen. Today we'll pray for an understanding of God's heart for the different people groups pertaining to North Korea. That would be the North Koreans, South Koreans, diaspora Koreans, and the lovers of Korea. So as I pray through the topics shown, please come into agreement with me, take up your authority in Christ, and lift up your own intercession. Father, we pray for the North Koreans. We pray, Lord, that they will know the delight and joy of the Father over them as your creation, your beloved. You have made them, you've crafted them in your image. You have such affection and longing for them. Lord, we pray that you will release your heart to them right now. We pray that you will make yourself known to them as the God of love, as the God who unconditionally loves and takes delight in them. Lord, we come against any feelings of abandonment or defeat and hopelessness regarding their situation. Lord, we can't imagine how difficult it is to be where they are, but we know that your presence is there. We know that you desire to reveal yourself to them. You desire to show yourself as a God who's never left, a God who doesn't abandon them, a God that doesn't leave them to their own devices. So God, won't you show up? Won't you show up? And Lord, we pray that they would grow in their knowledge of your word, that they would be able to hear your voice. And Lord, won't you raise up teachers of the word amongst the North Korean Christians, teachers who will effectively spread the gospel, truth, and love, and grace with your heart, with the Father's heart. And we pray that as they come into a knowledge of who you are, a greater understanding of your heart for them, that worship will increase. Worship will increase amongst North Koreans as a right understanding of you is released. As they understand that you are a God of justice, that you fight on their behalf, that you are heartbroken over their pain, their suffering, the death and fear that is faced daily. As they understand this, touch them with a whisper, a comforting presence. Touch them with a simple truth. And let them see you for who you are. Let them worship you for who you are. Let's pray.
Source, Lord God, of provision, of satisfaction, of fulfillment, of protection.
lift up the people of South Korea, the very brothers and sisters of our fellow North Koreans. And we pray in the spirit of 1 Peter 3 that we would have unity of mind, sympathy, brotherly love, a tender heart and a humble mind, that we would not repay evil for evil, but that we would bless. God, we pray for a brotherly love and affection towards North Korea in the hearts of South Koreans. We pray for all hardness to melt away. God, that you will replace all hearts of stone with hearts of flesh, that a desire for a reunified Korea would rise, a willingness to make room for family, for brothers and sisters, a willingness to be inconvenienced, a willingness to choose love over convenience. God, this is your heart. Your heart is one of brotherly love. So Lord, we come against every mindset that settles, every mindset of apathy, every mindset that doesn't want to pray, doesn't want to take action, that doesn't want to invite the North Koreans in. And Lord, we pray instead for hearts to be expectant for the impossible, for hearts to hope. Place of hopelessness and defeat, we speak hope. We pray for hearts to believe for redemption, to believe that you are a God that can bring reconciliation, that can bring healing, that can bring unity where it seems impossible in the physical and in the natural, where it seems impossible. Lord, we know all things are possible with you. So Lord, give us in South Korea a tender heart and a trust in who you are. Break down our walls, the walls in our heart that don't want to believe, that don't want to invite. But give us a willingness to be inconvenienced for the sake of family. Let's pray.
Thank you.
Next, we're going to pray for the diaspora Koreans. That means the ethnic Koreans, those of Korean descent who are born and raised elsewhere. Lord, we pray for a removal of any bitterness and resolving of hurt regarding Korea, regarding the roots for the diaspora Koreans. Lord, we know that Korea is one. It was meant to be one. Your heart is that this peninsula, this nation is one, and we cannot claim to love Korea if we only desire justice in North Korea, but we have bitterness in South Korea, towards South Korea. So come and heal our hearts, God. Come and heal our hearts of any bitterness that remains, and show us your heart, reveal your heart. And Lord, we pray that as the diaspora Koreans invest in the land of their roots, we prophesy that there will be a mutual blessing and healing from both sides, for the North Koreans and the diaspora Koreans, that both sides would step into destiny and inheritance. We pray that diaspora Koreans would claim their inheritance in this land, in a reunified land. And we pray, Lord, that you would commission and activate the diaspora Koreans all across this globe to pray with a sense of ownership, not from a distance, not out of obligation, but with a sense of ownership. That while it may feel like we are another degree separated from North Korea, we pray that, Lord, you would supernaturally impart your heart, that we would take it personally to know that our roots are tied to an undivided Korea, to one nation. Pray, Lord, that you would give us understanding. And first you would heal our hearts, and then you would release your heart. You would allow us to partner with you in prayer, partner with you to claim our inheritance, and pray that you get your inheritance in this nation as well. Let's pray. Father, you love North Korea and you are jealous for them to know your love, to know your promises and your heart for them. You want them to know that you're a God of compassion, you're a God of justice, you're a God who longs for them to be free. Lord, we ask that you would encounter them with your truth. Mold and make pliable the hearts of every group involved, the North Koreans, the South Koreans, diaspora Koreans, and those who simply love Korea. Mold us. Let us say yes and amen to your will, your purposes in this land. It's by your grace that each of us receive your heart and a revelation that produces a lasting conviction. Make us of one heart and one mind. Let us contend with faith and perseverance for a unified nation and people. We pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you for joining us this morning. We hope that you are blessed and praying for Korea. There's a lot of different things that are happening right now, especially in international relations and diplomacy. And in the midst of all these things, we want to make sure that we're covering these things in prayer, not from a place of anxiety, not from a place of begging God to do something that he doesn't want to do, but in full confidence that he's fully in control. So we thank you so much for partnering with us as we pray and contend for what God is doing in this nation right now. We have another watch tomorrow evening, Thursday night at 8 p.m. We'd love to see you there. And otherwise, we'll see you once again next week. We'll be praying for the nation of Israel starting this next Wednesday because it's a new month. And so we hope to see you once again. Have a wonderful rest of the day and have a wonderful rest of the week. We'll see you once again.